Seluruh negeri bersama-sama pahlawannya menunggu dengan berdebar-debar hati kelahiran negara dan zaman baru.
Presented when he was the Prime Minister, when he was alive, the symbol of a true human being that Malaysia needs.
When you're a kid in school and they always ask you who do you want to grow up to be, who are your heroes and stuff, I think the name Tunku Rahman really comes to mind.
Tunku Abdul Rahman was a class of his own.
He believed that there was no race. And everyone was a true Malaysian,
because he was the true Malaysian. He put you at ease immediately. Most of the time you're silent. And the atmosphere is a bit, you know, whether you can speak or not, a bit tight. And then suddenly there is a peal of laughter. And you know that Tunku has come.
Dan setahu saya tu, dia tak pernah anggap orang Malaysia ni sebagai you are Chinese, then you are Malaysia. Saya tak pernah dengar itu.
I will tell you, my own association with him, I met him at least 3-4 times. He was one of the warmest, humblest and cordial prime ministers that I have met.
Jadi orang tu senang. Senang di nak buat, nak jumpa ke, nak berbincang ke. Dia masuk semua. Jadi semua kata-kata kalau dia pergi pun orang kata tak payah nak cakap lah. Kalau buat appointment tu, kata dia, oh dia nak datang, sambut ramai. Kalau dia datang itu kenara-kenara pun begitu, kalau orang panggil, bukan panggil aku, aku pergi. Pun tak ada orang kata nak tunggu. Ada ha macam kita buat special lah, dia tak mainkan. Dia tak ada dia jalan sama.
Patriotism I think was number one to him. I think he made all the sacrifices he had. And the other virtue that he had was determination. And that was really, really powerful.
When we had the confrontation with Indonesia, what did he tell the Malaysians? Please go and enjoy your work and your dinner in the house and let me take care of the bullets and the guns that the Indonesians are firing.
He knew the need for unity of the country and he kept everybody happy.
And the step that he took, it takes a lot of courage and bravery to do, and I believe that not everyone can do what he does.
I think in the leader, what you really need is for someone that will fight for you.
And there was one occasion, a beggar, elderly beggar, somehow rather slipped in our group and faced him and said, Tunku, I'm poor, I have no money. Can you please give me some money? So Tunku, yes, he took out his purse and gave him 100 ringgit. And then he said, you don't have any clothing. He said, no, Tunku, I don't have a clothing. You know what Tunku did? He took off his shirt and gave it to him and they keep warm. And that poor guy was so frightened, he just ran away. So that is the kindness, you know, the heart of Tunku. He always cared for the people.
Apart from my own father, I always consider him as my father, because I mean we were all, I mean the way he treated us, not just like citizens, whatever race we were, whatever age, whatever position, he had time for us.
He brought together all our races.
A lot of things that he has sacrificed in Malaysia that many people don't know about.
Beliau sanggup turun bersama-sama dengan rakyat jelata untuk sama-sama memikul senjata, kalau ibarat senjata, ya, untuk memberi penerangan dan juga penjelasan kepada British pada masa itu bahawa kami orang-orang penduduk di tanah Melayu ingin merdeka.
We need his philosophy. We need his friendship. We need his wonderful leadership style. Because he cared for people.
So respect one another, care for one another, love one another, work hard, and love your country.
I used to visit him once a month. He was very sick. Even in sickness, he said, "How is that guy? How is this friend?" And nobody bothered him. So he died, a very sad man. And that is truly something he never deserved.